Subscribe now and press the bell icon. Never miss an update.
And if you like our video, you can just like on it. We are going to see 11th Standard Accountancy in Unit 1 Introduction to Accounting. We were seeing many topics in that introduction and evaluations of the accounting, and we were discussing about the other objectives, functions and importance of accounting in the few sessions before. Now in today's session, we are going to see about the basic terminologies in accounting. So when we are knowing about the basic terms only, we can move on to the accountancy. If you take off a science subject, there will be some basic terms. Like if you see about acid, base or some chemical solution names will be there. So that you need to know about if you want to go for the science. Likewise here also, if you want to learn about the accountancy, there are some basic terminologies which will be repeatedly we will be using in the accounting sums. When we go for the next chapters and all, you will be having a sums. So in that sums, if you want to do it, you want to know the meaning of a certain terms. That we are going to say about the terms in today's session. So before going on to the basic terms of the accounting, here I'm going to explain you about the four different words that you may know it, that you have learnt in your the lower classes also, but here we are going to use that word and related. So we will learn about it. First one is the producer, consumer, customer, supplier. Why I am talking about these four terms in before going for the basic terminologies itself, this is going to be the base word which I am going to use in each one term examples. So when I am using these examples, you should know about the correct exact meaning of these words, then only you can understand what are the examples I am giving you all. Now we go for the first word, producer. So the producer is the one who produces the goods. He may be or it may be of any manufacturing unit or any industry. Whoever produces the goods, we call them as the producer. Okay, so producer is the one who manufactures the goods, or he sells to the customer or any person, but he manufactures, that we tell them as the producer. Now we go for the consumer customer. So many will have a confusion with this consumer and the customer wordings. Okay, this we will be using many in the commerce as well as in the accountancy chapters where you will have this consumer and customer. So exact what is the difference, you should know about it. So let me tell you the meaning first and then I'll give you the examples so that you will understand in a better way. First we go for the consumer. So the consumer is the one who consumes the goods or uses the goods. We tell them as the consumer. So consumer is the one who uses a person who is going to use or consume the goods. We tell them as the consumer. Okay, what is goods? I'll tell you when you come for the basic terminologies. Okay, next we go for the customer. So the customer is one who buys the goods. So a person who is going to buy the goods, we tell them as the customer. Okay, let me give you a small example so that you will understand what is the basic differences between the consumer and the customer. So here we will take it off. Your father is going to a shop and he buys a notebook for all of you. Father is buying you a notebook. In the shop, he is going to and he pays the amount and gets the notebook. So, and he comes and gives the notebook to you. And you are going to use the notebook. So, in that situation, the customer is your father. Because he only has brought the goods. And who is going to use? You are all going to use. As a children, you all will be using. So, children is the consumer. Whoever uses that, we will tell as the consumer. Okay, customer is that one who buys and he gives to you for your usage of the note. And you are using the notebook. And this is what is the main differences between the consumer and the customer. Now, another situation where you will have the consumer and customer are same. Let me take off a person. Okay, A is the person. A can be the customer as well as the consumer. how A can be customer and as well as the consumer. He goes to ice cream shop. Okay, he goes to the ice cream shop and he buys the ice cream. Okay, so now A goes to the shop and buys the ice cream and he going to eat the ice cream or he going to consume the ice cream. So now in the situation, A itself is the customer and he is also the consumer. So it can be both together also. So you should know the slight variations we have is that one who buys is the customer, one who uses is the consumer. Why I am talking about these words is with these words only we are going to have the examples of all the basic terminologies. Next we go for the supplier. Okay, supplier is the one who supplies the goods. Now from the producer we are getting the goods in our hand itself. In the nowadays we have an advancement in the information technology. If you go and go for the any Amazon or Flipkart, we want to order anything, we are getting at our doorstep itself. That much of advancement we have at present. So one who supplies the goods, so one who is going to purchase from the producer and he is going to give it to the customer. The supplier itself can be the producer. So he himself can manufacture and give it in the straight to the direct contact he can have with the customer and sell it to the customer. So in that situation, producer and supplier can be same. Or the only thing, from the producer he can buy and supply to the consumer or the customer. So this is what is about the three, four words we have learned before going for the basic terminologies in accounting. Why? Because these are the words which we are going to use for the accounting terms. So basic term accounting terminology, first one we have is the transaction. I am going to explain all the 10 I have written. We have a more terminology. I have written first 10. So first we will be seeing the meaning and then I'll be giving you an example so that you can understand in a better way. First we go for the transaction. So transaction is the something where the transfer of money or money's worth goods is going to happen from one person to other person. We tell it as the transaction. So what is exact meaning? We are going to transfer the money or money's worth. Okay, it can be of other way also. So one thing is going to happen is from the goods we are going to exchange for the money from one person to the other person. We tell it as a transaction. So now we go for the example. We will have the producer. Okay, we are going to have the first wording itself. Producer selling goods for rupees 100. Okay, let me take a small example. Producer selling goods for rupees 100. Here what is happening? He is selling the goods to the consumer or a customer for how much rupees? 100 rupees. So there is a money, transaction is there. So 1% from the producer to the consumer, their goods is going to be transferred. So this is what is the transaction meaning. So whenever in the accounting you will be hearing of this word transaction, event, it is all same. Transaction is one from one person to the other person, the goods is going to be transferred for the money. When we have a money only, we will be having the accounts. When we are not having the money, then we will not take it into the accounts at all. That should be some financial in nature. That is very important. Now we go for the second information. We have the cash transaction. So in the transaction itself, we are having two things. One is the cash, another one is the credit. So for the transaction, any transaction is going to happen. If we give them the cash, if we give them the cash, then it is a cash transaction. We have the same example. We will have producer selling goods for rupees 100. Then the customer, if he pays the 100 rupees in cash, then it is a cash transaction. So this is what is the meaning. It can be of a cash payment or a cash receipt. So this is the example for the cash transaction. Now we go for the third one. We have is the credit transaction. So in the credit transaction, what we will have is, we will not pay the amount in the form of a cash. So in the form of a cash, the amount will not be paid. Other than we will tell it as a credit and we will pay the amount later on. We will not pay the amount immediately. If we have immediately, we would have paid in the cash. So we will pay it later on. That is what is the credit transaction. So same example, we will have producer selling goods for rupees 100. If the customer is not paying the rupees 100, he tells that he will pay later on, then it is a credit transaction. So this is what is the third one. Now we go for the fourth accounting terminology we have is the account. So hereafter, whenever you go for the other chapters, you will use this account very, very important. So whenever I tell account, all your mind comes to is you will be opening a bank account. That only all your mind will be striking off. I'll be having a savings account, a current account. So here we are not going to tell about the account of the what you are opening in the bank. Here we are going to see something is a different where it will be opened for the ledger purposes. We have in the accounting cycle, I have explained you in the last before session also. So you can have the YouTube, if you want go and search, you will be having that posting and balancing. In that I have explained about the ledger. In the ledger, you will be having a different accounts. That is what is the account for. Whenever we are opening for a person, for expense or income or an asset, or it can be anything. When we are opening an account for the ledger purposes, we will tell it as account. For example, we will see for this account so that you will understand easier. First one is that, let me take off Ram account. So we have opened account for the person Ram. Next we will see of the rent account. So for the expenses, I have opened the account. So whenever we are opening the account for our ledger transactions, then we will be having the account. Okay. And in exactly if you want to have this, all the transaction related to the rent will be entered. So from the financial year, in the financial year is what? You will be having from 1st April to 31st March. Okay, so this is what is your financial year. So from 1st April to 31st March, whatever the transaction has happened related to the rent, we will be having here. So the, in the accounts, what you will have, all the transactions on the particular head will be there in the accounts. So this is what is the meaning of the account. Now we go for the fifth one. Fifth one we have is the capital. So very, very important. For any venture or the organization, capital is very important. Without a capital, nothing can be done. So there should be a capital, very important. We will be definitely have in every form of a company. We have a different forms of the organization. We have a joint stock company. We have sole trader, partnership. There are a lot of different organization that you will be learning these all these terms of the companies in the commerce. Okay, so we have the different forms of the company. For each and every company, there is a capital requirement. Without a capital, nothing we cannot do. If you are planning in the future, I should have a open up of the company or anything, any shop. Let me take off a small shop I want to open. Your interest is opening a shop or something. Then for everything, we need of the capital. Capital is the investing which we are making at the starting point or the whenever we are commencing the business, whatever the amount is going to be invested by the owner who is going to invest the amount, we tell it as a capital. So capital, very, very simple, we can tell it as the amount which is going to be invested by the owner for commencing the business, for starting up the business. When we are going to invest the amount, we tell it as a capital. So for investing the amount, we will get an interest also. That we will be learning in next few chapters also. For the amount, whatever we are investing, we will be having some benefit out of it. Now we go for the next topic, drawings. So the drawings, what is drawing? Now we have learned about the amount invested, right? Now I have invested, let me take it off, 1 lakh. Okay, I have invested 1 lakh rupees in the store. I'm going to start up a small shop. I have invested 1 lakh rupees. So in between of the running of the company, I am having some requirement for my personal use. From the amount invested, I'm taking off, let me take it off, 10,000 rupees. Okay, for my personal use, I'm withdrawing from the 1 lakh 10,000 rupees. That we will tell it as a drawings. So drawings is the amount which we are going to withdraw for the personal use of the owner. It is not for the office use. Yeah, only for the personal use of the owner. I have some requirement at my, I have a health issue or any problem for any purpose of the, my personal, I have a requirement. From the amount invested, I'm withdrawing some amount. In that, we will tell it as a drawing. So the amount withdraw for the personal use is the drawings. Next we have is the voucher. So voucher, what is voucher? It's a printed document. Okay, so with the printed document we will be telling it as a voucher. We have a different kinds of the vouchers. Let me take off, invoice is also one kind of the voucher. And we have a bank payslip, payslip. These all the things we can tell it as a vouchers. One example is that invoice and bank payslip, cash memo. So this all comes under the voucher, where you will have the printed document like a receipt. So that we will tell it as a voucher. Next we go for the invoice. So invoice is something, is a document which is going, a statement which will be prepared by the seller. Seller is what? Seller may be of a producer or a supplier. Any person can be. So the seller, the statement they will prepare, what it will be having is, it will, in the invoice you will have the quantity, how much quantity you have bought, and the price of each quantity, price will be there, then total value will be there, and at present we have a tax also, so the tax percentage and everything will be there, GST will be there, and in that the seller detail and the customer detail will be there, and the seller GST PIN number. So this is all the details which you will have it in the invoice. Some of the details I have given, I am not giving all the details. So where you will have the seller name, address and the GST number, and the same way for the customer also, name and address and contact details will be there, and quantity what he has bought, and name of the goods, the descriptions will be there, price, value, total value, then you will have the tax. So this all will be there in the invoice. So in the invoice you will have all the particular details which I have told you. So it is, what is the statement? Who will prepare? This statement will be prepared by the seller. For the customer, he will prepare. So this is what is the invoice. Next we go for the very important word, goods. So in accounts and commerce, this word is very important, where each and every time we will be using it. So goods is nothing. We will be telling it as articles, or things, or commodity. That all material, that all is a goods. So goods is something where, now I have given a first example also, producer selling goods. So goods can be of anything, like it can be of a furniture, it can be of the plant and machinery, anything. Whatever it is, a material, we tell it as a goods. Any goods, it can be of a pencil, pen also, that it also comes under the stationery. So that is also goods. Now we go for the 10th one we have is the income. So income is that one who receives or earns from any other things, we tell it as the income. One, something we are receiving in the form of money. What are the incomes we will have in the account is, you will be having a commission. A small example, I'll give you as a commission. So commission is what? Instead of some other person, instead of you are going and doing some work, what you will do it is, on behalf of you, somebody will be doing other works. For them, we will be giving a commission. Like the same way, it will happen vice versa also. For, on behalf of the other persons, you will do some work and receive some amount. So that is what is the commission. We will be having brokerage, discount received. This all comes under the income. Or the sale. Sale is also one kind of an income. We are selling the goods and we are getting 100 rupees. So what is the 100 rupees is our income. So these are the few basic terminologies which we have discussed in today's session. We have a lot of more different terminologies in accounting. In the next session also, we will be discussing about the other basic terminologies in accounting. So today's session we have discussed about transaction, cash transaction, credit transaction, account, capital, drawings, voucher, invoice, goods, income. So 10 basic terminologies which we have learnt in today's session. In the next session, we will be continuing the same topic. Thanks for watching.